Hey everyone, I'm joined here with Simone after seeing the work Counterbody. Thank you so much for the performance.
Thank you for being here.
Well, a pleasure to see eight dancers.
Eight
on
dancers,
stage.
Yeah.
What a group work. How was it to work with eight performers in there?
Well, actually it was lovely because they come from different backgrounds and I had a lot of fun at the rehearsals. We laughed a lot.
Yeah.
Actually, we laugh a lot.
Yeah.
We are a laughing group. We worked around 2 months and a half, and it was tough at the beginning because of the movement language, but then it became fun, so yeah.
And so you say that the dancers came from different backgrounds, could you elaborate on that?
Yeah, like some come from contemporary dance, some come from circus, some come from street dance and urban and b-boying, popping, so different backgrounds for everyone.
Lovely.
Yeah.
And then in the piece, there's a lot of spoken text.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you could elaborate on that text. Is it something that, where did that text come from?
It is written by our dramaturg, Olivia Nitzisch, that she's not with us.
Mm-hmm.
And she has worked with us during the process of rehearsals and written the text. And part of the text actually is written by the dancers. And it's part of their experience with the movement and then edited by her. So it's it is more like a collective work on the text, like on the show also.
Yeah, and so just to go even deeper on that, what was, when you were working, what was the relationship between generating this text and then generating a movement vocabulary with the text?
Mm-hmm. Actually, it was the other way around.
Okay, first.
So first it was the movement and then the text came as a second layer, like the music and the video, and we had this idea to transfer the information from one part into another part. Mm-hmm. So it came during the process, but after the movement. It was not before the movement.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then I was reading about the work before I went in to watch it, and then you're mentioning that the work thematically addresses different philosophies and physics. And
yeah.
Could you maybe talk about how you address those themes into the work?
Mm-hmm. Actually, it was a different way of dealing, let's say, with theory, because first we came with this laboratory of movement, and then the dramaturg came and gave us hints about where she thought we would go, but it was like a very free and open
to begin with.
Yes, to begin with, but then we started to go with the material in a certain
Direct.
Way. But then with physics and with this thing with science, this is something that I am preoccupied, so that came from me, because I am preoccupied to work and with these principles of movement that come from physics and sometimes from neuroscience. So that was the work of me and Olivia combined in a way.
And is that, when you say you're preoccupied by that, is it like a personal interest or is it something you've studied?
It's a personal interest and I have started to study it lately in the last 2 years and work on this idea of non-localization, of the fact that if you move something, you move something in another part, so it's somehow in that direction, but it's still new and I'm still working on it.
So you're still researching and discovering.
I think I've researched a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, it started pretty soon.
Mm. And then regarding the visual language of the piece, at the front of the stage, there were two television screens.
Yeah.
Maybe you could.
It was done by a visual artist, Ciprian Ciuclea, and had a very interesting process also, because he shot the video just with the sensor without the objective in the front. Actually, it's just light that is impressed on the sensor, and all that you saw is kind of combined from this technique. It's a very simple video in a way; it's very minimal, but and we chose to put it like in front because we felt that it's a very nice dynamic between like the first two screens and what is happening in the back and the music.
Yes, that, create further three dimensions.
Yeah, that was exactly the point of putting them there.
And And my last question for you is, you're from Romania.
Yeah.
Yes. And how is the contemporary dance scene?
Oh, that's a very complicated question.
Okay. In a
it's very
kind
different.
Of summary.
It's very different. So it's very different because every choreographer has his or her own personality.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's developing, it's emerging.
Yeah.
It's gathering more public and
yeah.
more attention, but it's very personal for
okay.
everyone. So right now I can't really say that it's like this or it's like that, because I think it's more, it's very authoritarian, like
yeah.
Like an author work. So everybody studies in his or her own direction,
mm.
but then we have a lot of group works.
Yeah, is there like a community?
Yes,
there
yes,
is a community
of course.
Spirit.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
And in the last 2 years, this community has grown.
It's getting bigger and
yes,
bigger.
Stronger and stronger. I don't know if bigger, but stronger.
Stronger. Okay, yeah. The little birdie told me that you're very proactive in helping that community grow. So.
Yeah, I like to have friends.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, go and enjoy your evening.
Thank you. I will go to the party.
Yeah, go party and have a drink. And where's my co-host? Where is she?
Here I am.
I've missed you.
I've missed you, darling. Did you have a good day?
I did, but I felt so lonely interviewing you without you most of the time.
I didn't. I had lovely arguments.
I can't say what I'm about to say on a live stream.
Okay, so guys, we're about to wrap up, but I would like to take the chance to take you around the lovely foyer of Azarian Theatre, which is named after a very renowned theatre director here in Bulgaria, Krikor Azarian, who unfortunately passed away a while ago. But this theatre lobby is an homage to him. Krikor Azarian used to be a shoemaker for a very short period before he became the director that he is known to be. And the scenography here is done by the scenographer Nikola Toromanov, and he's using the shoe symbol as a symbol of humanity, of the humanity that Mr. Azarian's direction was known for. And we can come and take a closer look to this lovely environment. And Brenda is already playing with it.
I better.
And good news is, we have two shows tomorrow, first and last, Rec, and the last show tomorrow is also going to be here. So yeah, we're going to be back at Azarian Theatre, and now we're off to the party.
Have a drink,
yeah.
Relaxing time after a long day.
We hope you have a lovely Saturday night.
Yes, go wild.
We're definitely
but
going
not too
to
wild.
Have one. Not too wild.
We expect to see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow, 12 p.m. is our first performance Rec here at Azarian Theatre, or 11 CET or 10 UK time. That was all.
Sure.
Thank you very much. See you tomorrow.